this up. The new windsock ground stake with an 18 foot pole from my Para Orange Products windsock. Kick ass.
Well, I had a failed launch this morning, and by the time I laid back out, the fog kind of rolled back in. Those guys got off at a opening, and I didn't have a mile visibility, so I had to wait another 20 minutes or so. But I want to stay within the law and not launch in below required conditions. New wind and a very wet wing shouldn't be a problem. Clear prop.
Okay, roll on throttle. I just took off. So once I got the visibility on the ground, I was able to get up here, and it's absolutely beautiful.
Okay, note to self, make sure you tether the lens cover for the 360 camera. I got really lucky and it rode right here for the entire flight.
YouTube, Tim Muir asked me to talk about trims and letting out the trims. Much like when I was new and first started flying, I was really nervous about doing it. And it just took a little bit of time and a little bit of getting comfortable. So I'm going to climb up here. I got some nice altitude, and we'll go ahead and let the trims out. What I like to do is I just go ahead and stow my brakes. And I grab my trim tabs, and I just push them in with my thumbs. Gently try to let them out. I try to let them out as evenly as possible. Just like that. If you let one out sooner than the other, it'll just make you turn in the opposite direction. So it's not really a big deal. I mean, you can fly with one in and one out, and you just fly in circles. It's just that initial bump of it feels like you're dropping 6 inches or whatever. It's kind of scary at first. But you get used to it. And then when you pull them in, you just find the loops and just pull yourself up. The point is you want to make sure that both trims are in the same position. All the way up or all the way down or in between. That way you continue to fly in a straight line. And for me, it just took time just being in the air and getting more comfortable and under the wing. And eventually you don't think anything of it. You'll be in and out. Just remember to put them back in the landing position. I mean, you just make a fast landing, but just remember that trim position well before you come back to the field and make your approach to land. Well, that's the beautiful town of Ona down there. Not much to it. I mean, that's basically downtown Ona. I can smell it. So the Insta 360 1X I think will give me about an hour of recording time. So we're going to test that out today. I started it up and I'm just going to let it run until the battery runs out. I think I got a 128 gigabyte card in there, so it's not going to run out. See you over there, Cal. Don't worry, I'm going the other way. Let's go back and see if we can find some pigs. I saw some when I took off and they were fogged in. It wasn't worth the risk to try to drop down and chase them. Well, there's a flock of turkeys right there.
Carl.
Daryl's not with us today because his wife had to have some surgery. We hope Amity's doing okay and will be back on her feet soon. But Carl decided to be a good husband and stay home and take care of his wife. Thanks to my buddy David Wolf, aka Paramotor Crazy, for the t-shirt. I love footies. They all sport it. I like everyone. Doesn't matter to me what you fly. I think we're all the same. If you fly, you're a friend of mine. I'm gonna drop in for a flyby. My buddy Michael Gillespie. No, negative, that's not. Their 172 is blue and white. This one is pretty much all white. Nothing like getting high in Wachula. Man, I bet you guys get sick and tired of hearing me say Wachula, don't you? Wachula, 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 Wachula. All right, I won't say it anymore today. Taxi in for takeoff on 36. You know the name of the airport. I won't say it.
Say that guy in the 172 is flying a gigantic pattern. He's turning final about 2 miles. It's another one in the downwind now.
Sam, just falling. This is a good call. Just going to move quickly out of the southeast. Maybe 1-2 mile an hour.
Roger that. I'm going to drop altitude out here and get below pattern and head back for the field.
Hey, Moss.
Holy cow, what a great flight. It was nice up there in the air, about 70 degrees. I got up about 2,000 feet. It's so hot and humid down here. Gorilla Ground's in the truck trying to cool off. I'm packing everything up. So thanks for coming along, guys. I hope you enjoyed the flight. Until next time, Gorilla out.